All right, this Valentine's Day, if you're looking to impress the one you love, there may be no better way than with their sweet tooth.
I think that's a very accurate statement. And a French pastry is sure to impress, but have no fear. Southwest Tennessee Community College's chef Steven Leake, a new award winner, by the way, has an easy recipe we can make at home. First of all, that award, congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
What's the award?
Well, it's an award, a national award across the country, so it's 1,100 community colleges. And so this award is actually recognizes outstanding faculty at these schools.
That's so awesome.
So out of the 1,100 schools, they chose 58 candidates. And so we'll fly out to Maryland, and everybody will receive their award.
It's definitely well deserved, well earned for sure.
Thank you very much.
You're in good hands if you want to learn how to work the food business here in the Memphis area.
Wait a minute, you are still hard at work though.
Yeah,
as we were talking, what are you working on right there?
So this is the little icing that goes on top of the puff pastry here, and just making a little design in it.
That's so pretty.
And so we just take this, and we just we'll switch out plates with it.
Okay.
And this actually goes on top.
And you actually made that? Because that looks like a work of art. I mean, I'm not surprised. But
so this is actually a store-bought puff pastry.
Because
to make the puff pastry dough is very
time-consuming. But you took it from dough to that.
Yes. And so,
you think I can take it from dough to that?
Yeah, because the simplest part about it is, you know, you just bake these. And so I took two sheet pans with parchment paper and just placed it on there and put one of the pans on top.
Okay.
And just put it in the oven and baked it for 15 minutes.
Why do you put one on top of it?
Because we don't want this to rise. You know, puff pastry.
That's right.
The French term for this, which means 1,000 layers.
Chef, take us inside that mind of yours. When you do something, when you come up with a creation like this, what are you thinking about, especially for a holiday like
Valentine's? Well, you know, the one thing about this is a classic French recipe.
Yeah.
So it's been around for a while, but it's one of my favorites because I really like puff pastry.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then, so it has a combination of several things that I like. The puff pastry, the pastry cream, which is just basically a custard that's been thickened with aluminum cornstarch, and then the fresh berries. And
it's
so to me, that's a light, very airy dessert, and it just goes well with any occasion.
It's very impressive, let's be honest.
And particularly for Valentine's.
Impressive.
And so I got a couple of nice big strawberries over here. I'm just going to dip these in a little bit of chocolate.
Ooh, now you're really showing out.
Just to accent a little bit.
So how long a process is this? Because you've baked this off. This takes
So that's 30 minutes.
Okay, that's not bad.
So the process for this is when you take this out of the freezer, you want to take your fork and you want to what we call dock it, which means we're just going to poke holes through all the way through the dough.
Okay.
Dock it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then prevents the dough from rising as you bake it. Because if you don't, then it's going to puff up like five times the size.
So 30 minutes for that, and then you need to let it cool, I assume, before
so you let it cool completely, and then you can cut these to whatever size you want. And so I just cut them to these little rectangular squares here.
And I guess you could make your cream.
You want to make the pastry cream. So, like, it's a good idea to make that the day before because you have to let it cool.
Okay.
And then you do want to be careful when you're making the pastry cream because once it starts to thicken, it goes pretty fast.
Okay.
So you want to make sure you're paying attention to it to make sure that it doesn't overthicken.
Can you put that also on top of what we're looking at right there?
If you were going to put something on top, if you weren't going to put the icing on it, then you could do powdered sugar. Or you could take a little bit of whipped cream.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. And this icing looks really thin and where it kind of...
It's very simple. So it's basically just confection sugar, either water or milk.
Okay.
And then to make the chocolate, you just take some cocoa powder and add it to it.
You know, this seems pretty decadent. Is it?
Boy, also. I mean, and then you run it through like you have
to make
the
like the little spider webs.
Let me see if I can do that.
There you go. So this is a little bit thin. So what you want to do is make sure that when you make this icing that it's it's thicker. So yeah. you'll have to use more confection sugar and less of the liquid of the water.
I don't know.
Or milk.
I kind of like this.
I tell you.
It's gonna
be
a good, I do too.
You can make
it's going
like
to be a good Valentine's
heart.
Day for someone.
Oh, most definitely.
For sure.
Yes, it is.
And then we're gonna, you serve it with a little bit of Prosecco here. Goes great for your Valentine's Day.
We are ready to go.
And not a calorie in the thing.
Chef, thank you very much. Happy Valentine's Day. Congratulations on your honor
thank
also.
Thank you very much.
All right.